Hi, welcome to Prep Talk. I'm your host, Jay Seymour, and with me is Matthew Roach, who's a senior program manager for the SQL Server team. But Matthew, before you worked for us, you had a real job, and we're here to talk about 70-463, implementing a data warehouse with Microsoft SQL Server 2012. It's one of the MCSA for SQL Server exams. So tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm a senior program manager on the SQL Server team, but before I joined Microsoft, I actually worked as a data warehousing and business intelligence consultant. So the topics that are covered on this exam and a lot of these concepts, this is what I did 80 hours a week for the better part of 5 years. So real pleasure to be here today.
Great. So let's start off by explaining who should take this exam.
Well, I think the short answer is anyone who's working with SQL Server 2012, either as a DBA, database developer, or BI consultant. Even though the focus is on data warehousing is really becoming more and more of a common, really baseline set of knowledge for a database professional, not only for people working in the BI space.
Okay. The exam starts out with designing and implementing a data warehouse. What does Microsoft mean by a data warehouse, and why is this topic important to DBAs?
Well, in this context, we're really talking about the relational data warehouse that sits between your online transaction processing or OLTP systems and your downstream BI application. So if you think about designing your standard transactional application, you normalize your database. This is really optimizing for data manipulation and the change of data. This makes for great transaction speeds, but it's kind of poor for reporting and analysis. Your relational data warehouse is broken down either into a star or a snowflake schema, just a different shape of the data to make it easier for analysis with a different focus on things. And making sure that you know how to both design and implement a data warehouse is really key to being successful for any of the downstream technology applications.
I have no idea what any of that meant. I'm an infrastructure guy. Star, snowflake schema, that sounds really exciting.
Well, if you think about it, most of the questions that you ask, I want to see sales by region, by day, by employee, things to that effect. Inside your schema, your facts in the center, so these are the numbers that you want to roll up, that you want to aggregate, and around it, you've got all of the different dimension tables, so anything that you would say X by Y, so sales are your facts, sales by region, by date, by employee, date, region, employee, product, supplier, customer, etc. These are all the dimensions.
Sure.
You actually structure your data so that it's designed to be analyzed, just a different way to design things.
Okay. So you mentioned data. There's a lot of data. We use that word a zillion times on this test. Can you talk a moment about how that data flows and why I should care and how that ties in with what you were just saying?
Yep. So if you think about the source system, you've got all these little highly normalized tables, you know, designed for transactions.
Yeah.
You have a different physical shape in your data warehouse. So you actually need to extract the data from the source system. You need to transform it into the different shape.
Okay.
You need to load it into that data warehouse. This is where SQL Server Integration Services comes in. And there are topics on the exam talking about extracting, transforming, and loading the data. This is really focusing on the control flow and the data flow, setting up connection managers, working with expressions, choosing the right tools, be they tasks, transformations, or other components, to actually implement this, to go from point A to point B, or more likely, from points A, B, and C to points X, Y, and Z in a real enterprise data warehouse.
Okay. Now, on this exam, we use the acronym SSIS a lot. Now, as a kid, I always thought that meant silly string is super, but I'm starting to think that's not right.
Yeah, well, silly string certainly is super. But SSIS stands for SQL Server Integration Services. This is our flagship enterprise ETL, or extract, transform, and load tool. This is one of the core topics that's being measured and tested on this exam. If you don't know integration services, if you're not sure how to create a project, deploy a project, configure it, run it, and build it to solve your business needs, you're definitely not prepared for this exam. Even though this is not an SSIS exam per se, this really is an exam where integration services is one of the key topics being tested again and again and again. If you don't know SSIS, make sure you look at the skills measured to see where you need to ramp up.
Okay. You know, another acronym, or not acronym, but another saying that I've heard is garbage in, garbage out. What skills are we testing that will help with that sort of modality?
Oh, so that's an awesome question. If you take a look at the last group on the exam on the skills measure, it's talking about building data quality solutions. And this garbage in, garbage out is something that plagues data warehouses and BI applications, and honestly, any type of data-centric application. Essentially, user entry error, bringing systems together that weren't meant to work together. It's very, very common for this type of application. And what we're looking at here is how we can both eliminate the problem data from getting into the system in the first place, perhaps using SQL Server master data services as the system of record for your core dimensional data, or correcting problem data, correcting dirty data once it gets in, using a tool like SQL Server data quality services. And DQS is brand new in SQL Server 2012. Okay. Master Data Services was introduced in SQL Server 2008 R2, but 2012 is a major update to the product. So understanding how to use them, how they fit into the solution overall, it's really going to be key to being successful on the exam.
Okay. So in your opinion, what do you think is the hardest thing on this exam?
So honestly, I thought the exam was beautiful. It was it was straightforward. It was real world. It tested the skills that I had used as a BI consultant. Yeah. You know, I've taken a lot of exams over the years, and this is, you know, from technology speaking, this is my baby. This is where I've built my career as a technologist. So I thought that the exam was real world, spot on, tested the skills that you really need to know to succeed in the real world.
Yep.
So if something is hard, it's the fact that you can't read a book and prepare for this exam. You really have to have the hands-on skills to know not just what the tools do, but when you'll apply them. You need to be able to look at a problem and choose the right solution for that problem.
Well, that's awesome. That's great to hear.
Yeah.
So thank you, Matthew, for being here. I really enjoyed it.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Jay. It's been a real pleasure. And everyone, get out there, take that exam, and hopefully you'll love it as much as I did.
70-463, implementing a data warehouse with Microsoft SQL Server 2012. It's one of the exams for the MCSA for SQL 2012 SQL Server. So go take that exam.